So if you're just tuning in, well, it looks like lap two. Sam Swift looks like he has a pretty good lead. From an assumption, I'm guessing it's 1. Oh no, I was gonna say one, but it's actually 2.2 seconds. Looks like Hugh Janis had a good start. Is up to third. Mattis Maxi fourth, and Delano's lead had a bad start. And down to fifth, I guess he lost at least a. Oh no, actually, had a good start. I'm sorry, I take that back. Forgot he had a penalty. So he's up into fifth, but Jay Bradfield, who started from the back of the grid, is up to ninth. And oh, Andy Lou almost chops him off a little bit there. Going out of turn four. But it looks like Jay Bradfield also has a three. Guess he has a 3 second time penalty? Yeah, it's a 3 second time penalty. So he has multiple warnings, of course. But he is alongside Andy Lou into turn nine. He's got the inside move done. Great move by the Alfa Romeo up into. Hugh Janis does not have DRS, so he's going to be under pressure from the Racing Point. He's just a little bit too far back. Delano's right behind, along with Gunnar. And Scepter 3 yellow, and Beard Dave's out. And I think is that a full course safety car? It is a full course safety car. It didn't pop up for me. I had to pause.
I don't know, but we'll lead the green flag once more on the restart.
Him to Captain Infinity to LPE was Sam. Sam Swift under bringing the pressure against the AlphaTauri on the outside. He's gonna try. Oh, he walks up his brakes a little bit there. LPE spun around. LPE has spun around. He's hit the wall. Coming out of turn two. That is unfortunate for LPE. He's also got damage, I believe, out of that as well. Yes, he does. He's got an end plate.
Well, Crazy Bill also is on five lap old cars, so his tire's a little bit younger, but they're still a little bit cold compared to Gunnar. And actually, if Chris Malabai decides to not pit, he would be in second, but if he does, then that would mean this would be the battle for the
feed there coming out of the exit of the corner, so I'm guessing might have been caught up in that dirty air somewhat. And I think this is now where he should be able to pounce on him. DRS open. Will he get the move done ahead of the Ferrari? And yep, that definitely looks like a move done easily before even the corner. As Sam has now gone into the pits. So, interesting. So where is he going to come out? So he's going to come out. He's going to come out behind Sam. Or it's not Sam. I'm sorry. He's going to come behind Max. Sam, why did I say that? All right, so. Oh, and he almost. I'm guessing those hard tires might be crying a little bit, though, too, because. Yeah, there you go. There's Cryptic Alibi coming closer and closer. 6.4 seconds right now. It is going down immensely. Mattis Max is losing nearly 1.5 seconds per lap. Go back to the leader, though, as he's coming to the final couple of corners. Sam Swift, the reserve driver for Mercedes-Benz, comes around the final corner now. And he comes across the line now to win the Australian Grand Prix, and he wins it by a distance of 17.1 seconds. Mattis Max will come home in second place. A good driver overall, and will finish in second place for Racing Point. Cryptic Alibi will finish in third, but that ain't gonna hold because Delano's will jump him into the podium position and gets third place. So Delano's gets the third place finish. Jay Bradfield from 19th on the grid to 5th comes up in 5th place, and actually he gets jumped by Captain. Oh, he's going to get jumped quite a lot. I forgot about the 12 seconds of penalties. So Baseman goes up to the 5th, Yun Zombie goes to 6th, Captain Infinity goes to the 7th, Gunnar goes to 8th, Jay Bradfield will unfortunately go down to 9th, but that's still a good drive though nonetheless. From 19th on the grid to 9th place. Andy Lou will come up in 10th, and Crazy Bills, unfortunately with his internet issues, will have to settle for 11th place. Swan Shank will finish in 12th, 4th, gained 14 positions. That's still a good drive overall in my books. And there is your race winner, Sam, on the podium, the top step of the podium, with Mess, Max, and Delanos. Delanos, who had a five-place grid penalty to start the race, definitely made it up by gaining a podium, so that's still a good drive for him overall as well.